Hi, I'm Dr. Tracey Marks, a psychiatrist, and I make mental health education videos. Today, I'm talking about executive functioning, what it is and what it looks like when it's not working optimally. This is part one in a series of videos talking about managing ADHD symptoms without medication. ADHD can be thought of as a disorder of executive functioning, so understanding this is an important lead-in to making behavioral changes. Executive function is a set of cognitive or thinking skills that are responsible for the following: planning, organization, and prioritizing, initiating actions, self-inhibition, self-monitoring your behavior, being able to shift your attention between tasks, and working memory. That's a lot of stuff, so let's break it down. First, planning, organizing, and prioritizing. This involves any planning on a global level. It's not just planning a party. It's the ability to anticipate how long things will take or how much effort things will require, or thinking through multiple steps to see something that you want to do all the way through to the end. Problems in this area can look like being unprepared for something, even though you had adequate time or resources to do it. You may have trouble managing your time properly because you can't look at various pieces of information and easily tell what's the most important thing to pay attention to. So instead, you may spend your time frittering away at something that doesn't matter much while leaving the most important thing incomplete. Next, initiating actions. This involves taking action to get started with something. Anyone can put things off that they don't want to do. But trouble with initiation is at the root of procrastinating. It's like there's a block to being able to just do it. So if you have trouble in this area, you may need lots of pressure and prodding to get things done. So let's say you have a big project to complete, and that project is going to take a lot of work and a lot of planning. The person without trouble initiating will be motivated to get it out of the way so that they don't have to think about it anymore. The person who has trouble with initiation doesn't use this same kind of reasoning. They don't factor in the stress that it will cause having to do things at the last minute with not enough time. They can just still sit there and be immobilized and unable to start the project and put it off until the last minute. Self-inhibition. This can be thought of as impulse control. It's the ability to hold back from automatic responses because you're able to anticipate what impact your action will have. Trouble in this area can look like interrupting people or even making quick decisions or snap judgments. Self-monitoring. This skill is the ability to look at your behavior and measure your progress against what others expect of you or what's needed of you. If you have trouble in this area, you may tend to have no idea what you're doing and how it impacts others. You may have trouble accepting feedback from people because you don't see what the problem is. You don't see that you're consistently turning things in late or being late has a negative impact. In fact, you may forget that you're always late. And it's not that you don't remember that you were late. You don't remember that you have a pattern of being late or a pattern of being unreliable. Ability to shift between tasks. Some people refer to the skill as cognitive flexibility. This is a skill that involves being able to shift attention from one thing to another and also involves being able to respond and adapt to change. If you have trouble in this area, you may be considered to be rigid in your thinking, and you may be unable to deal with any kind of change from the way you think things should be or from what you were told. Or you could have serious trouble multitasking. The last skill is working memory. And this is the ability to keep things top of mind, to be able to retrieve and process recently learned information. And this skill is important for problem solving and decision making, because with those mental processes, you need to be able to take the information that's in front of you and manipulate it in a way that helps you make a decision or solve a problem. So if you have trouble in this area, you can have trouble with problem solving and analytical thinking. Also, if you have inadequate working memory, you could have trouble making appropriate adjustments to your behavior because you're not taking into consideration factors that should affect your current decisions. For example, going back to the example of always being late, Inadequate working memory plays a role in your inability to remember your pattern of always being late. It's like yesterday is forgotten and every day is just a new day. The control for your executive functions is located in the front part of your brain that includes the frontal lobes and other structures such as the basal ganglia, which are further down from the lobes. Executive function is also controlled by your prefrontal cortex, and this matters because that's where the stimulant medications work. There's many conditions that could impair your executive functioning, and some of these are depression and a traumatic brain injury. A traumatic brain injury occurs when you have an injury to your head that disrupts your brain tissue. Alcohol can also temporarily impair your executive functioning. And if you have a stroke that occurs in the frontal part of your brain, you can have trouble with some of these functions. I mentioned earlier that ADHD causes a lot of impairments in executive functioning. The stimulant medications like Ritalin and Adderall work to increase dopamine in the prefrontal cortex. But even with medication, many people are still left with difficulties managing some of these functions. And cognitive behavior therapy focuses on managing some of these executive skills. I'll talk in another video on tips to manage some of the executive dysfunction that comes with ADHD. But first, I wanted you to understand the nature of the problems, that is, the executive skills, and how the dysfunction falls into certain domains. Stay tuned. See you next time.